Hello everybody and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and today we'll make this easy exercise for beginners in SolidWorks. And we have here the drawing. Okay, here it is. It's very easy. And we're gonna start with this part in the middle, which is like a rectangle. Then we're gonna make this part, then this part, and then this other part. So let's begin. It's very easy. First, let's open a new part and let's change here the scene. We'll change it in plain white. And now we'll open a sketch in the top plane to make that rectangle. And we'll select center rectangle and we'll make here two rectangles. Just like this. And now it's smart dimension, let's define them. So first, this line here will have 36 millimeters. And this one here will have 12. From this one, here will be 6. And this one right here. Actually, let's not dimension it like this. From this line to this one, okay, from this one to this one, here will be also 6. Nice, now go to features, use extruded boss base command, and here will be 36. Perfect, press OK. And now we'll have to make the next part. So we'll open a sketch on this face. And here we'll start with line, so select line, we'll start from here, down, and then something like this, and here we'll make an arc, okay, and then line again, back to this point. Select this line and make it horizontal, select this point with this line and select here coincide, and now with smart dimension we'll have to define this. First, from this point to this line, here will be 24. And second, here will be, this arc will have radius 18. And now this is fully defined. Code features, use extruded boss base command. And we'll have to select here reverse the direction. And the thickness will be 15 millimeters. Nice. Press here OK. Nice. And now we'll have to make this part, we made this part, and I'll have to make this upper part. Let's do it. To make this upper part, we'll have to open a sketch on this face. Nice. And now we'll select line and we'll start from this point till this point, and then up like this, and back. Make a sketch not like this. Let's delete this line here. Was my mistake. And here we'll need a small line up and then to this point. Nice. Now we'll select these two lines and we'll make them parallel. And now with smart dimension we'll have to define this sketch. First, from this point to this point, here will be 16 millimeters. Okay, and then this line here will have 9 plus 9, 18 millimeters. Okay, and then from this point to this point, here will be also 16 millimeters. Nice. This line here will have 15, as we can see. Okay, and now from this point. From this point to this line, here will be 21. Okay, and now we'll have to delete this parallel here, and with smart dimension we'll give a dimension from this line to this point, and here will be 18 millimeters. Nice. And now, as we can see, the sketch is on this face and we need the extrusion to be here. So we'll go to features, we'll use extruded boss base command. We'll select here an offset. Here, instead of sketch plane, we'll select offset. The offset distance will be 24 millimeters, and here will be 18 millimeters. Perfect. Press OK. Nice. And now we'll open a sketch on this face, and here we'll start with a circle, just like this. Then select this point with this one. Select here, make vertical, and I will make a center point arc, just like this. Select this arc and this edge. Select here, make tangent. Do the same with this arc and this edge, also tangent. And now select this point with this one. Select here, make horizontal. Okay, and now it's my dimension. We have to define this circle. Here the diameter for this circle will be 9. Now I'll have to select line, and we'll have to make here 3 lines to close this, because we need these corners to be cut from here, removed. And now if you want to fully define this, we can give here the dimension 15. Just be careful this line to be outside of this edge, up. Nice, now go to features and use extruded cut. And here instead of blind, we'll select up to next, press OK. And that's it for this part. Now we have to make this other part here. Okay, to make this part, we'll open a sketch on this face. And here we'll start with line. So select line. We'll start from this point and down, and then like this. Here we'll make an arc. Okay, let's select 3-point arc. And let's make an arc like this, and then select line again and go up and like this and back to this point. Select this point and select here, make tangent. Do the same with this point, select and here tangent. And now it's my dimension. Let's define this. First, this arc will have the radius 32 millimeters. Okay, and then this line here will have 12 millimeters. Nice, this line up here will have 14 plus 14 plus 2, 30 millimeters. Okay, and now the height of this will be from this line to this one, and here will be 76 millimeters. Nice, go to features, use extruded boss base command, and here let's select reverse direction, and we'll use again offset instead of sketch plane. Offset, the offset distance this time will be 6, and the thickness for this will be 15. Reverse here the direction for this offset, press OK. Nice. Now we'll have to open a sketch on this face. We need to make that hole and that cut here. So first we'll start with a circle. Okay, select this point from the middle of this edge with this point. Select here, make vertical. And now it's my dimension. Let's define this circle. First, from this point to this edge, here will be 24 millimeters. The diameter will be 18. This is fully defined now, and now select line, and we'll start a line from here, go up and back to this circle. Select this point with this circle, select here, make coincide, and now select these two lines and make them equal. And now it's my dimension. We'll give a dimension for this line, and here will be 2 millimeters. And now with trim and tease command, we'll cut this part of the circle. Press OK, go to features and use extruded cut, and here instead of blind we'll select up to next and press OK. And now we have only one more thing to do, will be this small hole here with diameter 6. we're gonna use hole wizard for this. We can see that is on the middle of this face of this edge, and it's at the distance of 6 millimeters from this edge. Okay, so let's do it. First select this face, select here normal 2, and then go to hole wizard. We'll select here this one, hole, ISO, drill size, the size will be 6, and here we'll select up to next, and that's it. Go to positions, select here 3D sketch, place the hole, and now we'll go to smart dimension, and first let's select center line, and we'll make a center line from this point until this center point. Select this center line and select here make a long I axis, and now smart dimension will give a dimension for this center line, and here will be 6 millimeters. Nice, and press here OK, and that's it, we have the hole. And this was the tutorial for today. Thank you for watching, and if you like it, you can leave a like, you can subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this, and if you want, you can leave a comment with your opinion. Thank you, and I hope to see you in the next tutorial.